Quantum engineering is trying to exploit quantum mechanics, a 100-year-old physics theory, in order to develop new technologies such as computers, sensors, materials that take advantage of the subtle properties of quantum systems. There's a variety of different techniques we use. We use magnetic fields, we use electrical fields. We basically use any field or any property of nature that we can to probe these systems. One of the most popular is lasers or light fields, as this is a very non-invasive way of interrogating various quantum devices. Well, LIGO is an example of the levels of precision one can obtain if you push towards the quantum limits of a measurement. People that were interested in performing gravitational wave detection were way ahead of their time in thinking about how quantum mechanics limits one's ability to measure things. So one big takeaway is that the continued push on the technology and the engineering in many ways mimics the sort of work that needs to be done to develop other quantum systems like quantum computing. The Kavli Nanoscience Institute is a very important vehicle, facility, for developing new types of devices, because the devices and the fabrication techniques that the Kavli Nanoscience Institute has allows us to develop devices down at this submicron, even sometimes sub-nanometer scale. And that's the scale that's required to control quantum systems and to develop new types of quantum devices. Well, it's very early days, and it's not certain exactly how quantum technologies might impact society, but there are several areas which we believe there's great opportunity. One is in the area of computing. Quantum computers are potentially exponentially more powerful than classical computers. There's new materials. You get emergent phenomena from quantum systems that might have radically new properties that we could exploit. There's also the way we sense the world around us, and quantum mechanics has different rules about how we sense the world around us. And there's also communication. When we communicate information, quantum mechanics says there's different rules for how that happens versus classical communication. And so there's opportunities for new types of communication schemes and techniques as well. In many ways, we're probably limited in our imagination and how this is going to change our lives. I think it's a very, very tough problem, but a very important one. So that's the key. There's lots of good solutions, but it's when you find these important problems to work on. And I think this is one of them. And I think Caltech is in a unique position to really be at the cutting edge, to really have an impact. It's what drives me every day. The gold systems behind me is what's called the dilution refrigerator. This allows us to cool samples down to 10 millikelvin or so a few thousandths of a Kelvin above absolute zero. And at those temperatures, you remove all the most of the environmental noise that might perturb the quantum system you want to study. So in this case, we're studying electrical circuits, superconducting circuits, and the goal is to build the components that might make up a future quantum computer.